Hi friends, welcome to CC Academy. Today I am going to discuss a topic called Introduction to Trigonometry. This topic comes from the past time CBSE. So the topic name is Introduction to Trigonometry. First of all, we should know about what is trigonometry. The word trigonometry comes from the Greek word such as trigonometry. Tri means three, gono means sides or angles, metry means measurements. Therefore, trigonometry means measurement of three sides or angles of a triangle. So that we are going to discuss three sides and angles measurement of a triangle in the trigonometry. First of all, we should know which are the sides and which are the angles comes in the triangle. Here we have a triangle ABC. In this angle B is right angle, and there are two angles called angle A and angle C. Here we have angle A and angle C. These two are called acute angles because these two angles measures less than 90 degrees. So these two angles are called acute angles. This is called right angle because it measures exactly 90 degrees. So we should discuss trigonometric ratios here. There is a topic in the introduction to trigonometry, that is trigonometric ratios. Trigonometric ratios. Before going to discuss this trigonometric ratios, we should understand which is opposite side, which is hypotenuse, and which is adjacent. See here, we have a right angle here, that is angle B. The side which is opposite to right angle, that is called hypotenuse side. I will repeat once again, side which is opposite of right angle, that is called hypotenuse side. And then we have a opposite side here, side which is opposite to a given acute angle. If we are taking sine of angle A or cos of angle A, which angle we are taking as a theta, that opposite of that will be the opposite side. Here opposite of theta is BC, is that this BC is called as opposite side. And side which is adjacent to theta, that is called adjacent side. So that we have three sides such as opposite side, adjacent side, and hypotenuse side. Using this, we can go for the trigonometric ratios. There are six trigonometric functions. I will take here one. First one is sine theta. Sine theta is one of the function, and second function is cos theta. Third function is tan theta. So I will take first sine theta. What are the ratio of sine theta? We have a shortcut formula I will take here to remember this trigonometric ratios. SOH. So and CAH. Yeah. And TOA. TOA. So yeah, TOA. To remember the trigonometric ratios, we have given the shortcuts. Here S means sine theta, its ratios opposite by hypotenuse. O means opposite, H means hypotenuse. Here also same, C means cos theta, A means adjacent side by hypotenuse side. Likewise, T means tan theta, O means opposite side, A means adjacent side. So I'll take here sine theta. Using this, opposite by hypotenuse. For cos theta, kia is the CAH. Adjacent side by hypotenuse. For tan theta, opposite by adjacent. So we got three trigonometric functions and its ratios. Likewise, we can find another three trigonometric ratios for the trigonometric functions. we have a sine theta here. Reciprocal of sine theta is cosec theta. Just we need to make the reciprocal. What is there here? Opposite by hypotenuse, we should write hypotenuse by opposite. And here we have cos theta. Reciprocal of cos theta is secant theta. That's equal to just we need to make a reciprocal means numerator into denominator, denominator into numerator, so that it becomes hypotenuse by adjacent. Here we are taking the name of the side, hypotenuse side, adjacent side. I am writing a shortcut. At last, one more, cot theta. That is reciprocal of tan, so that it becomes adjacent by opposite. So this is how we can remember the trigonometric ratios. Using this, we can find some problems or numericals. I'll take one example here. Given that example one, given that tan A is equal to 4 by 3, and find all other trigonometric ratios, they said. We should find all other trigonometric ratios, that means except tan, we should find all other 5, such as sin theta, cos theta, secant theta, cosecant theta, and cot theta. So first of all, I should take right angle triangle here, and we can give the name ABC. A and C are both are acute angle here. They asked to find given a tan A, so that we should take theta as an A. So tan A becomes 4 by 3. What is tan theta? I have given a shortcut TOA. Tan means opposite by adjacent. So that which is opposite? BC is opposite of angle A. And then which is adjacent? Adjacent to angle A is which one? BA or AB, that is 3. So we don't have AC, that we should find by Pythagoras theorem. We have a Pythagoras theorem. What is that? AC square is equal to AB square plus BC square. So using this, we can find the value of AC. AC is equal to square root of AB square plus BC square. AC is equal to square root of AB square, means here we have a value 3, 3 square, and BC square means value 4, value of BC is 4, so that 4 square. AC is equal to square root of 9 plus 16. AC is equal to, we will get square root of 25. Finally, we will get value of AC is 5. We got 5 here. So that in terms of K, we can take K means any real value, so that we can find all other trigonometric ratios. I will take one by one now. So first one is sin A. So actually, while giving the formula, I have said that sin theta. Theta in the sense angle here, acute angle. Instead of theta, they have taken A, so that we can take directly A here. Sin A. So sin SOH, I said. So means SOH. Sin theta is equal to opposite by hypotenuse. Which is opposite here? In terms of name of the side, I will write. Opposite side is BC here. Opposite of angle A is BC. And adjacent side, hypotenuse side is AC. BC by AC, that means what is the value? 4k by 5k. So that ratio, it becomes 4 by 5. This is sin A. Then you go for cos A. That is equal to CAH. C means cos, A means adjacent, and H means hypotenuse. So that adjacent is AB by AC. AB by AC, that's equal to AB value is 3k divided by AC value is 5k, that's equal to 3 by 5. This is the ratio of cos A. Then you go for cosecant. Already we have found tan, so that we will go for cosecant A. Reciprocal of sine, so that you can write directly 5 by 4. I will go for secant A. Reciprocal of secant A is cos, so that I will take directly 5 by 3. And one more we left, that is which one? Sine, cos, cosecant, secant. One more. Cot. Cot we can find directly. Here we have a value, reciprocal of tan is cot, so that cot A is equal to 3 by 4. These are the all 6 trigonometric ratios regarding the given value, that is tan A is equal to 4 by 3. This is how we can find the trigonometric ratios using one function. That's how we can find. That's all from the today's session. I will coming with a new topic in the next session. Till then, bye.